Hi, I'm Megan. In this episode of Deep in the Sheets, we'll look at 15 Excel hacks to increase PPC workflow.
Number one, automatically sum.
Quickly add up an entire row or column in two steps. One, click into the cell or column that you would like to be adding. Next, hit Alt plus equals. Boom.
Number two, network days function.
Using the network days function is a fast and easy way to determine how many weekdays are in the month you'd like to look at. Simply hit equals, network days, add a comma in between the 2 months, and there you go. This is very effective if you or your client do not wish to run your budget on weekends.
Number three, Control Plus.
When you're hundreds or thousands of rows deep in data, getting back to the beginning or end can be a lot of mindless scrolling, but it doesn't have to be. All you have to do is hit Control Up to go to the beginning or Control Down to go to the very end. Use this in combination with Shift to highlight an entire row or column.
Number four, repeating a formula in multiple cells.
First, type in the formula you'd like to copy. Hit enter. Next, put your cursor into the cell that you would like to copy from. Drag it down to the right-hand corner box. Once the plus sign shows up, double-click. And easy, copies all of the formulas into all the cells. Well, that was easy.
Number five, copying patterns.
All you have to do is highlight the pattern you'd like to copy and drag down as far as needed. Easy peasy.
Number six, tabbing between worksheets.
Simply click Control Page Up to move left or Control Page Down to tab right.
Number seven, trim function.
The trim function removes all spacing between text except for single spaces in between words. So right here we have an unnatural space before the word brand. We'll go in here, hit equals, trim, close it out, double click, and it has taken away all spacing before the word brand.
Number eight, transposing.
The transposing function will change rows to columns and vice versa. To do this, highlight the table, copy it, and use the paste special function. In here, just click transpose, and there you go. Data in a different view.
Number nine, format painter.
If you've ever spent more than 10 minutes trying to format a document, simply use the Excel format painter to duplicate cells. Simply copy the cells or rows that you would like to duplicate the formatting from. Double-click the format painter. And easy as that. Copy all the formatting into any cells you desire.
Number 10, lend function.
Avoid manually counting each character by highlighting next to the cell that you would like to count. Hit equals, L-E-N, parentheses, the cell that you would like to character count. Close it off and hit enter. Drag down the formula by hitting the plus sign and dragging down.
Number 11, proper function.
Easily capitalize the first letter of every word by clicking into the cell, typing in equals proper, and voila.
Number 12, lower function.
Conversely, type into the cell equals lower, and it will take all of your title case letters to lowercase.
Number 13, concatenate.
The concatenate formula combines data from two or more cells into one cell. It's very useful in tracking URL parameters or building out URLs. To do this, hit equals, and then simply just add the ampersand in between all cells that you would like to merge. There you go.
Number 14, conditional formatting.
Conditional formatting allows you to automatically change the format of a cell based on the parameters or values that you define. Let's say we want to take a look at the conversions within the campaigns as to which one is performing the best just based on color alone. Highlight the conversions that you would like to look at, convert conditional formatting. You can do this based on data bars, based on color scales, and based on icon sets.
And last but not least, number 15, pivot tables.
In this session, we're just going to teach you how to create a pivot table, as we have a whole episode of Deep in the Sheets dedicated to pivot tables coming down the works. So, to create a pivot table, we're going to highlight all of our data in our table, hit Insert, Pivot Table, and you have the option to choose New Worksheet or Existing Worksheet. From here, you can play around and drag and drop which data you would like to parse. With these easy tips, you can increase your PPC workflow.